Looking for just the right home? Start with AccessLasVegas.com. We've got more real estate listings than anyone on the web. AccessLasVegas.com, the best local site on the web. Web search is giving you unexpected results? At AccessLasVegas.com, you get exactly what you're looking for because local sites are reviewed before you search. AccessLasVegas.com, the best local site on the web.
Back with more Travel Channel Presents.
Las Vegas. But the Reverend Tommy Starks is a seasoned casino chaplain who's well acquainted with Vegas psychology.
The alluring attractions of a casino floor is that you suddenly are in a suspended animation. Feel like you're in a dream world or a fairy tale world. If you stand in the middle of a casino, it's hard to find an exit sign or you'll never see a clock. When I cross the casino floor in a hurry trying to get to my next Bible study or next counseling appointment, I have to zig and zag. It's almost like a maze, and that's the way the casinos are drawn. Part of the allurement of a casino also is the noise level, the volume. They put the 10 buckets at the bottom of each machine and stand in the middle of a casino where there are 250 machines, and somebody will be winning at every moment, and you can hear the coins dropping into the bucket with the boop, 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 boop kind of sound. It attracts your attention, and before you know it, it becomes mesmerizing. About an average of once a day, when I'm walking between the machines, somebody will say, "Hey, Father, bless me or bless my machine," and so I just wave my hand in the sign of the cross, or I give a nod or a smile, and they say thank you very much. And then there have been occasions in which they would come back and try to give me money from, and I said, "No, you take your money home to your family." Come on. No, I go to many casinos three or four during the week to meet with staffs. Hotel staffs, casino staffs, and they give me 5 minutes to give a motivational, upbeat speech that gets everybody in the right frame of mind.
I thought being a Christian is writing down 17 things you like to do and quit doing those and then being miserable the rest of your life. Because they told me as soon as I became a Christian, you can't dance, drink, smoke, shoot pool, play cards. And when I go lecture on gambling in places like Alabama and Florida and Georgia, they tell me you can't be a chaplain in a casino.
When I came to Las Vegas, I saw it as a challenge and an opportunity, and I still do. In fact, if you consider this to be a parish, I'm thinking this is the most challenging one in the world. So, yes, it's a challenge, and yes, it can be discouraging, but I get daily feedback from people who are getting better. One misconception about Las Vegas is that there is a direct connection between suicide and gambling. Now, Las Vegas does have, per capita, the highest suicide rate in the nation. But a woman who runs the suicide prevention line and takes over 2,000 calls per week told me recently that there's no connection between suicide and gambling. Hardly anybody will call and say, "I've just lost all my money, I think I'll commit suicide." Rather, there is a direct link between drug abuse and drug usage and suicide. Almost every person who calls and says, "I'm about to commit suicide," is high on some kind of drug. There's a verse in the Bible that says, where sin is, grace may abound. And God's grace means forgiveness for those who don't deserve it. And I don't know anybody who does. And so the people who are gambling and drinking alcohol and the people who are neglecting their families, they deserve God's love and grace as well as anyone. And so I walk right past some of what people call sins. And I've learned to look at sin, which is more of an attitude. And I hardly anymore even smell the smells or see the sins.
One person who Reverend Tommy Starks has been able to help is Gail Day. Gail works for a marketing company in Las Vegas.
Her particular compulsion had to do with video poker. And she, by her own description, would sit for hours, lose track of time, lose track of the money that she was spending, and she attended a meeting or two of Gamblers Anonymous. Thank you, Lord God, for this food and for a friendship and for an opportunity to be together. In Jesus' name, amen. Why do you think machines would be more addictive than table games?
Because they don't talk back. They don't cause you any pause or hesitation. You can sit there and go as slow or as fast as you want, and you're becoming obsessed with making this your escape, so nothing else seems to fill that gap. I guess it would be very similar to a person with an alcohol problem or a drug problem. So when I go into a casino, which I have to do because I have clients there, and I see a situation where I know I can sit and play for an hour or two and the machine looks so good, I put my blinders on and I head straight to the parking lot and walk straight out. And it works. That's what I have to do. It works.
With the compulsive person, whatever it may be, gambling or any form of drug usage, there are a lot of slips. I'm going to be clean and sober for 6 months, then I'm going to get drunk. And we have to be patient with those people. This is Billy Rush, my good friend, for about 14 years. Billy's been a stagehand at Bally's in the Jubilee Show, a long-running show here in Las Vegas. And Billy served prison time. He served 5 years for attempted murder. And that was largely related to drugs, wasn't it, Billy?
Yes.
What were you doing at the time?
Downers and smoking marijuana and drinking.
And you ended up stabbing a guy, right?
Yes, in a fight.
And you admitted to your guilt, and you said you were in the federal prison where you were, there were 350 guys, and you were the only guilty guy.
I was the only guilty guy in the prison. Everybody else was framed.
When you accepted the Lord, I'm not quite sure what that means.
I realized that my life was empty, and I needed to fill it. Uh-huh. And a friend of mine shared the gospel with me, and I know that's what I needed. And I got on my knees that night, and I asked Jesus into my life, and he took my drug habit that very second and changed my life completely.
I know you well enough to know that backstage you're sharing your life story with a lot of stagehands, and you want them to know that you found some meaning and you found a direction. How do they respond?
Most of them say that's fine for you, but it's not right for me at the time. Whenever anyone's hurting, I'm the first one they come to. They might laugh at me when they hear the story, but when they're hurting, they come to me. I don't hide my testimony from nobody. I tell them where I was and where I'm going.
Uh-huh. Where are you going?
I'm going to heaven.
Are you?
Amen, brother.
I would find it boring anywhere else. If you asked me to go be a chaplain in Phoenix or Seattle, I'd probably say no immediately. God would have to call me several times to get me to leave Las Vegas, because it is an exciting place to minister.
Planet. Break away with Megan to Micronesia.
Let's hit the town!
A Pacific paradise where you can hang out with turtles or get a tattoo. It's also one of the wettest places on Earth, with waterfalls, scuba diving, even waterbeds. Oh. And where there's water, there's jellyfish and eels. But don't worry, they're not for dinner. Fruit bats are.
Bat-terrific.
Break away with the next all-new Lonely Planet. Wednesday night at 8 on the Travel Channel.
A deluxe apartment in the sky. Baby, moving on up to the east side. We finally got a piece of the pie.
know I wanted a home, a showplace, a Taj Mahal, but finding a solid mortgage was harder than finding Bigfoot. So I went to Priceline.com and got my price on a great mortgage with guaranteed closing costs, no points. Look at me, neighbor, I'm king of the cul-de-sac. We finally got a piece of the pie!
InsidePrudential.com, there's so much you can do and learn. Hear what our stock market experts are saying. Learn all about IRAs and 401ks. Get an instant life insurance quote, or even find a new home. Prudential.com has all kinds of interactive tools to help you save, plan, and invest. It's so easy to use. And there's always something new happening, from insurance to real estate to investments. It's all right here at Prudential.com.
There are lots of tempting computers out there, so how do you choose? This one looks appetizing, but does it include internet service? This one looks good, but does it come with a free color printer? Now, a Gateway Essential PC comes with an Intel Celeron processor, year of AOL included, free Canon printer, and you can trade it in toward the purchase of a new one after 2 years, all for just $999. So, come and get it. Call 1-800-GATEWAY.
Hello, Mosquito.
Hello, Mosquito.
Have you heard about the website Discovery.com?
No.
They have a very useful travel section.
I love to travel.
They can help you research and book your trip and get local health warnings.
How interesting.
Buzz, 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 buzz.
I cannot live another day without air conditioning.
Says tomorrow's gonna be hotter.
Hotter?
Like yesterday.
Yesterday? Yesterday you said you'd call Sears.
I'll call today.
You call now.
I'll call now.
There's still plenty of hot weather to come. Fortunately, right now, you can get big savings on an installed central air conditioner from Sears. For a limited time, we're offering a hot summer special. Absolutely no payments, no billing, no interest until this fall. Call Sears today for a free in-home estimate on an energy-efficient central air conditioning system. And now you can choose from two high-quality brand names, Kenmore and Trane. All our work is done by professional Sears cooling specialists, with satisfaction guaranteed or your money back. Soon, this special deal will be gone. Call Sears today, your total solution for cooling system sales, installation, and service. Sears Home Central, the good life at a great price, guaranteed.
So what's the paper say about tomorrow?
Another scorcher.
Cool.
Tomorrow on Travel Channel Presents, spend an evening exploring the facts and fiction about UFOs. First at 8, begin uncovering the evidence and decide if you think alien aircraft really do exist. At 9, learn what secrets the government is keeping about UFOs in the Nevada desert. Then at 10, hear firsthand accounts of alien sightings from around the world. Travel Channel Presents, tomorrow night starting at 8 on the Travel Channel. We're back with more Travel Channel Presents.
Although Las Vegas couldn't really exist anywhere but America, the place doesn't exactly conjure up apple pie, happy marriages, and well-adjusted kids. Well, meet Sarah Fulco. She's 9 and a half and was born here. Her doting parents both work in the casino industry.
I think Las Vegas is quite interesting because it's like having the whole world right here. And, you can do all sorts of stuff, like, for instance, the roller coaster at New York, New York. That's a certain building. And it's like having the Statue of Liberty right in front of you, because they miniaturized it so it looks like there's New York City. And they built in a roller coaster to make it more fun. And I went on that roller coaster, and I'm never going on it again, because it scared me half out of my skin. I've lived here all of my life, and so when I first saw the buildings, I was just a tad scared, not that much, because When I first saw the buildings, I thought they were huge, like giants, like I'm a little ant. But once you get used to it, it's not really a big problem.
Before I even came out to Las Vegas, I never thought I'd be involved in gaming before. I really didn't know much about it, but now that I've been in this a long time, it's a nice occupation. It's a clean job, really, besides the smoke in the air, you know. But it's a nice living. It really is. It's easy work overall.
Well, I'm also in gaming, but he's who I watch. Except I'm not a crap deal. I deal roulette mostly, but we have fun because we directly deal with the people. I do. I have hands on them because I actually take the cash and put it down or pay them. So I have direct contact. You know, no stress, only what you create yourself. You have a good time, you do your job well. It's fun.
Me thinking of the Strip, it's having you going anywhere you want. It's free. And you can do all sorts of stuff. You can gamble, which is not for me. You can go to the bars, which is not for me also. And you can watch the shows there, and you can do all interesting stuff.
Oh, remember that one guy at school?
Hey guys, see? This is where I won.
This is where I won the beaver and the little bear.
Oh, that's cool. I almost won that one.
Hey, Jackie, look, it's your number.
Yeah, number 6 is my number.
I've known Jackie since I started softball, and that was about a year ago. And this is Melissa. I've known her since kindergarten, and when we really got together was in second grade.
I'm totally scared of roller coasters.
Oh, same here.
I'm a little iffy on roller coasters, just sometimes they make me meh.
In the never-ending battle for tourists, the casinos have realized that theme parks for kids are good business.
I went on the pirate ship. It was really scary.
Yo-ho-ho.
Well, not that scary. First it started out really slow, and then it went whoa.
But on some of them, they actually go upside down.
Yeah, but I don't like that.
That was cool.
There's movies, lots of good ones. There's all the casinos, which you lose lots of money on, so they're rigged.
Only stay in them and watch the shows.
Because they watch the shows, that's good.
What do you think about it?
Wait, I'm not done.
Okay.
I got one more thing. And the lights are cool. The light, it's really neat.
Like on holidays
and stuff, especially the, what's it called with that big, the big dome and then with all the pictures? That long thing?
No, I don't know.
We have no idea what you're talking about.
It's
next like, subject. What do you think?
Okay. Yeah. I like the malls. I like
oh yeah. That's me.
Okay. I like
the stores.
I
don't like you what? Like the mum?
Yeah.
As they're growing up, they're going to find out more and more what a casino really is. I mean, they don't really understand it at 9 years old, 8 years old. But eventually, as they get older and older, it's curiosity. They see all the lights and all, then they see what's going on, and you have to explain it to them, you know. That's it. You got to put them on the right path to, you know, exactly what gambling is, or what it's really all about.
Casinos have no bearing except they don't even know that it's our income. My kids don't even look at a casino as a casino. They know that's where mommy and daddy work. It's as if we worked in a potato chip factory.
One of the most important days in the Las Vegas calendar is Super Bowl Sunday. People come from far and wide to gamble on the event, with total bets in excess of $100 million.
In the last 10 or 15 years, they marketed Super Bowl so big in Las Vegas. Instead of being at the game, you're in Las Vegas, with all the big screens, all the sports books, all the festivities, you know, and everything, which just became, It's like the second Super Bowl, really, Las Vegas.
Walk in the end zone on that play.
Every year, my dad and my mom usually watch the Super Bowl, and they root for certain kinds of teams, and they, you know, they cheer and they, you know, they go boo and stuff.
I'm gonna pew.
Usually, my dad, he invites his friends over, and sometimes they bring their wives over.
Go! Oh!
Hold this way. Go back.
It's quite happy in Las Vegas for a 9.5-year-old. And it gets more interesting as you get older. And once you can play all the different games there, not exactly kiddie games, but the roulette, video poker, spin the ball thingy, like that. But I don't think I'd really try it because it's just a waste of money. That's my opinion.
In Berlin, high above the city streets is a place to leave behind the hustle and bustle. But you'll also have to leave behind your clothes. This hidden haven is a nudist colony. Forbidden Berlin, Monday night at 9 on the Travel Channel. Why is truth stranger than fiction? The new Curious World, weeknights at 7 on the Travel Channel. Curious World, weeknights at 7 on the Travel Channel.
It's a symbol known across North America and a sign that Prudential real estate professionals are at work using innovative tools to bring buyers and sellers together. Put a Prudential real estate professional to work for you. Call 1-800-THE-ROCK.
Let's take a trip back to a time when memories and music were made to last. Now, Cornerstone Promotions brings you Rockin' Instrumentals, featuring 34 of your all-time jukebox favorites. These are the songs that bring back magical memories. Instrumental music at its best. That blasted from your car radios. Here are the songs that made cruising so much fun. So many fun-filled hits. Rockin' Instrumentals. 34 original hits by the original artist together in this one great collection. Is not sold in stores. Here's how to order. Call this toll-free number now for Rockin' Instrumentals. Two cassettes, $19.98, two CDs, $26.98, plus $4.95 shipping. Have your credit card ready and call now.
You were away for a week, and your washer sprung a leak. Better call for your free improvements catalog. It's packed with answers to problems you didn't even know you had. Quick and clever solutions for your home, your yard, and your car. And some exclusive products you won't find anywhere else.
Call 1-800-221-6771 for your free improvements catalog. And we'll give you free shipping on your first order. Call now.
Got a lot of stuff. With the free classifieds at AccessLasVegas.com, you can sell your unwanted stuff without spending a single penny. And then buy something you do want. Free classifieds at AccessLasVegas.com, the best local site on the web. Are your talents going to waste? Visit the job channel on AccessLasVegas.com, powered by Headhunter.net. Find a job that makes the most of your talents, or stay right where you are. accesslasvegas.com, the best local site on the web.
Hello, Meteor.
Hello, Meteor.
Have you heard about the website called discovery.com?
Discovery.com is my guidebook for life. I learned how to plant an herb garden, train my dog, and cure my dandruff.
I learned that most meteors burn up in Earth's atmosphere. The atmosphere.
We're back with more Travel Channel Presents.
The flip side of innocence is decadence. Legendary gambler Bob Stupak certainly extracts maximum pleasure out of life in Las Vegas. Bob opened one of the city's first budget resorts. He's made fortunes and lost them. But his legacy to the city is its tallest landmark, the Stratosphere Tower. Bob has a simple philosophy. Everything in life is a bet.
Life is a poker game. So everybody in life gambles one way or the other. When you go to work, when you fly in an airplane, everybody gambles.
Aside from the millions he's won and lost, Bob's biggest gamble was with his own life.
In 95, in the evening, I took a motorcycle ride. Went down the street. Car pulled out in front of me. When it saw me, it stopped. If it went forward, kept on going, I'd have missed it. Just a second in time. It's just lucky, unlucky. You know, people saying I was lucky because I survived it. But I think that I was unlucky even having it. But I hit the car. I didn't go anywhere. Broke the legs. Broke the arms. Broke the face. In a coma, took a long time. A long time to come back. Everybody in life has a number, and that number is the day you die. Well, I had a terrible accident that day, but my number didn't come up. That's why I'm still here.
Bob plays poker most days. Today, he's looking to take $10,000 to the table. But because of his reputation as the meanest player in town, finding a gambling partner is becoming increasingly difficult.
Hello, Billy. Yeah, how are you? How'd you do? Did the Super Bowl treat you right? Yeah, well, look, I'm just wondering if you have some time today. You want to meet me down at the Strat and maybe we'll just play a little poker. Well, couldn't have been that bad. I understand. All right. Well, give me a chance. All right. Well, give me a call if you feel like playing. You know where to find me. All right. And I'm sorry about the Super Bowl. Talk to you later. Bye, Billy.
Because of his flamboyant lifestyle and a history of big bets, many people in Vegas call Bob Stupak a legend. It's not a view he shares.
Legend theory is other people's perceptions, not mine. You know, Abraham Lincoln or Moses, I'm too young to be a legend. I'm a mere mortal alive today.
Yeah.
Puggy.
Yeah.
This is Bob.
Oh, Bob. What's going on, pal?
What's going on? We're going to play. Now, is 4 o'clock a good time for you?
That sounds good.
Now, we're going to play at the Stratosphere. So, I don't want you to be embarrassed when I knock your brains out.
Everybody knows I'm the Ayatollah.
Yeah, I know. Okay. 4 o'clock at the Stratosphere in the poker area.
Okay, I'll see you there.
Okay, buddy, bye.
Bye-bye.
When Adam bit the apple, he was gambling on Eve. He got unlucky. But that was the first gamble in life, and it's never stopped.
Thank you.
came here in the early 70s. I got a limited license for a few slot machines. What I did differently back then, the highest jackpot anywhere was $186,000. And I opened my place up with $250,000. So the first day I opened up, I had the reputation of having the biggest jackpot in the world.
Honey, get out of from behind the bus. Just pretend like you're a fire truck. Anybody here?
Every bet is an individual bet. Every day is an individual day.
Yep, I have the right box.
The most a person can gamble, any person, is it's an easy one. All he has. So if they only have $10 in their pocket, that's all they have. And they bet that. No one can bet more than everything they have. Go to the bathroom. How you got attention was you have to put your hand up. That got the teacher's attention. You'd ask the teacher permission to go. When you get attention, you have to be taller. So I decided to build a tall tower in Las Vegas. The name just came about one day. Stratosphere, it sounds high. Las Vegatize it. Just can't have a tower people go up to. So the Las Vegatize it, put the roller coaster on top. Simple as that. And I used to say, well, when that tower is built, you'll never get lost again, because no matter where you are, you can always look up and you'll see the tower and it'll give you direction. And the tower is me, and that's why Las Vegas and myself just became interchangeable.
Pug, this is me. Don't leave right now. These guys put me on the damn strip instead of taking the freeway. So right now we're, where the hell we at? Right now we're in front of Caesar's Palace on our way to your place.
Now,
where do you want to sit?
We're playing Kansas City lowball. The lowest hand is the best. Aces are high, so the best hand you can have is 2, 3, 4, 5, 7.
I mean, I got to come in for 1,600. This is unbelievable.
There you go.
Well, I'm not going to do that.
Hey, you look at your cards? You ain't going to do it?
I mean,
too late. You already looked at your cards.
Yeah, but I've got all this.
You got to go for the 200.
I got to go.
No, you
got to
throw it out.
I play poker. Do I play it well? Yes.
Well, I mean, every time I play, I mean, they just keep giving me my top card. I mean, I can't make a hand.
It's tough.
Sometimes you really have a hand, sometimes you bluff. So when I'm in doubt about a hand, there's two things I'll do. If somebody bets me, I'll call it and move all in, or throw the hand away. You always let it up to the other guy. It's been successful so far.
I never get two looks. I'm not even going to shake your hand, Bob. Yes, I will. Yes, I will.
All right. Well, it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
All right, now loan me $10,000.
The advice I would give would-be gamblers, the strongest advice would be forget it. Do other things in life. Go see a movie. Go read a book. But if you have to gamble, you just absolutely have to gamble. Then the best advice, get on a plane, get on a boat, come to Las Vegas, do it all here. Because we always need the money. We're in the middle of the desert. Might have to build something else. And they can contribute to a worthy cause. The great city of Las Vegas, the most exciting city in the world.
Travel Channel presents. Spend an evening exploring the facts and fiction about UFOs.
first at 8. Begin uncovering the evidence and decide if you think alien aircraft really do exist. At 9, learn what secrets the government is keeping about UFOs in the Nevada desert. Then at 10, hear firsthand accounts of alien sightings from around the world. Travel Channel presents, tomorrow night starting at 8 on the Travel Channel.
Today on Amazing Destinations, we're off on a politically charged quest.